want God to know that you appreciate him. You want the church to know that God has been good to you. You want to come out and testify. Amen. I want to thank God for my life and my family. It hasn't been an easy week. The enemy is fighting constantly in all areas. Hallelujah. But we know we are more than conquerors. Thank God that we are alive. He put food on our table. Even in the difficult times, he's always with us. Praise the Lord. Tonight I want to talk about rebellious and witchcraft. Rebellious and witchcraft. Hallelujah. When we talk about witchcraft, I need your attention. I need all the attention you can give me tonight. I really want you to learn tonight. When we say somebody is a witch or somebody is a wizard, we only think about the person that is flying, the person that is eating meat, a human body, the person that is drinking human blood. Amen. Praise the Lord. Now, the definition of witchcraft or being a witch or wizard or being bewitched go beyond that. Amen. Now, in the Bible says in Galatians chapter 3, verse 1. Let's open to Galatians chapter 3, verse number 1. Now, according to dictionary, the term bewitchment or bewitch means to place under one's power by or as if magic, or to cast a spell over, to captivate completely, or to be captivated completely, to enchant, to charm. Hallelujah. To entrance, meaning to enter the person, to be transformed, to be possessed, to be captivated, or a spell bound. A spell bound. And so when we say rebellious and witchcraft, they have a common thing. They operate in a common area or common field. Hallelujah. Anybody that is a witch is also a rebellious person. Anybody that has a rebellious spirit in him or her also is operating under the same thing as witchcraft. Hallelujah. So in other words, you can be bewitched to do something that somebody can look at you and say you are a witch. How many times do you look at somebody and say you are a witch because of what they did against you? Because of the behavior you saw them behaving. Hallelujah. Sometimes you see the countenance of somebody, a person change, and you get scared. And you know that's not a person you knew before. Hallelujah. A person can be bewitched and begin to do things that the witchcraft are supposed to do. In other words, you can be captivated to perform certain things that the witch or the wizard or the witchcraft or magic, somebody who uses magic, will do. I don't know if you're getting it. Again, you can be charmed to be forced to do certain things that under your normal thinking, your normal mind, you will never do those things. I don't know if you are learning. It means that you can be possessed to do certain things that is not a normal way of you doing things. And after, most of the time, after finishing doing all what you did, you come back to your senses and ask, what did I do? Why did I do this? Praise the Lord. So you see, there are people that have suicidal thoughts. They are bewitched. Nobody in a normal sense will go and climb a tree and say, I will drop myself and die. Nobody in a normal sense will conceive for 9 months
And some time will come and the person will
drown his children in a pool of water.
It is a sign that that person is no longer in the normal mind that God created him or her to become. A spell has been cast on that person. Listen to me. For some time, I'm trying to teach you how to disconnect yourself from Satan. Because many of us, we are living in the church. We come to church every day. The witches and the witchcraft, and those that are using magic and spell, are still able to connect to us and cause us to become rebellious. And when we become rebellious against God, or against His word, or against His desires, what happened is that we have become the same like the voodoo priest who is doing the witchcraft himself. Hallelujah. And so we see Christians who are so rebellious, you can never get them to do anything that is right. Because to them, nobody has the right to tell them what to do. It's a sign of rebellion. And we see that in the country we live a lot. And it's like everybody has a right. There's no mother, there's no father that controls them. And coming from the childhood, the parents does not even have the right to tell them what to do. So you tell a child to sit down and say, no, I want to stand. That's the spirit of rebellion. It is the same as a witchcraft operation. So anybody that has a rebellious spirit in them, they are so difficult to operate. They are so difficult to work with. You can never do anything with them that it will work. You say, let's put this thing together. They will say, no, we will not do that. We will rather separate it. You can't do nothing to them with them that it will work. It is a spirit of witchcraft that has entered Christians. Hallelujah. It's just like when we were in the world. That's what is called for gods. When we're in the world, you're looking for a beautiful guy and the guy is not helping you to love her. You go to this voodoo priest and this obvious, and they ask you to bring a lock or locker. And they put the name of that guy in that locker and lock it. And put your name together. As long as that lock is locked, now the girl does not have any toys anymore. It is called spell. It is witchcraft activity. So, what do you see now? Whatever you tell the girl to do, they become like a robot. They just obey without a word. I was watching a Facebook yesterday. There's this pastor in South Africa. And this year, 2014, this is it's a new thing there. He said he was going to get the church members to eat from the heaven food, manna, whatever. And looking at the video, they were spellbound. Everybody was in a position like being under the anointing, but you could see it's not the anointing, it's demonic. And then he said, go out there, there's a food out there. Go out there and eat. And everybody left the church and went to the bush. On the grass. They ate the grass like goat and sheep eating grass. And you could see they are not normal. They even, there was one girl, it looked as if she has already become mental. Stupid. Eating grass like. Yeah. It's amazing. This is what Christians want. These are the people they want to follow. Those of us that will help you, that will teach you the truth, that will get you to love God, you don't want. So when I see some things like that, I just keep quiet because people want these things. The name of men are tongues. If you show genuine love, Christians don't want it. Hallelujah. They want somebody that will put them under a bound. A spell. So think about it. If this pastor will tell a girl, Let's go to bed. Do you think that girl will be able to say no? Huh?
No.
He told you to go eat.
Glass.
Glass. And you went to eat glass like you are not in the normal mind.
The video is there.
On my Facebook wall. Go and look at it. You'll be shocked. So a whole congregation. More than 30 people. Boys and girls, men and women, everybody went out there eating glass like goats and sheep. They were under a spell. That is witchcraft activities. Amen. Listen. And so anybody that has a spirit of revenge in him or her, even in the church, we see these things all the time. Church start 8. But the person decided that as for me, I will always come to church 10. Because by the time I reach church, the open prayer has finished. Pastor is already has finished preaching now. We're doing miracles. So I know I only come at the time when there's miracles. That's a sign of rebellion. You know why? You want to do what you want to do, not what the church says we all should do. Even though at that time you know you were not doing nothing, you could have come to church. Hey, that's a sign of rebellion. The Bible says we should pay our tithe and offering so there will be food in the meat. You say, ask for me? No, the pastor will eat my tithe. So I will not pay my tithe. The pastor will eat my tithe, so I will not pay. Who told you the pastor is eating your tithe? Did I read the Bible? Hallelujah. That is a sign of. You see, we don't look at it as if. We only think that when we talk about witchcraft, we think about somebody who's drinking blood. Let's go to Galatians 3. You will understand proper. Chapter 3, verse 1. Galatians chapter 3, verse 1. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Anybody? Uh-huh.
Oh, foolish Galatians!
Who has bewitched you? You should not obey the truth.
Uh-huh.
Before the eyes you see Jesus.
Jesus Christ have evenly set forth among us.
Uh-huh. Hallelujah. Amen. Any other translation? Galatians chapter 3, verse 1.
You foolish Galatians. Who has bewitched you?
Before your own eyes.
Jesus Christ has clearly portrayed.
Hallelujah. You foolish Galatians, who has bewitched you? It means that even though you are a Christian, you are a child of God, you can be bewitched to disobey the word of God. Hallelujah. It says, who has hypnotized you? That's what my translation says. You foolish Galatians, who has he hypnotized you? It means bewitchment, means being hypnotized, meaning that you are no longer in your normal senses. You are being controlled by a force that is stronger than you. It is possible to be rich. Hallelujah. That is why sometimes you see a married woman still having sex with other people outside there. It is easier to be bewitched if you don't study the word of God and obey the word of God and it's being preached every day in this church. Somebody out there can bewitch you and you'll be forced to do certain things you wouldn't want. By the time you know, you have already done those things. Hallelujah. That's what they call enchantment. Have you ever seen there are certain people that are walking with snakes? Snakes.
Whoa.
And they can speak to the snakes to do certain things, and you see the snake doing it. Hallelujah. It's called enchantment. When they put that charm on you, you will not be able to do what you want, but rather what they want. That's what the Bible is talking about in Galatians chapter 3, verse 1. Who has bewitched you? Who has hypnotized you? Before whose eyes Jesus Christ was vividly portrayed as
Verse 2. I only want you to learn this from you. He says, did you receive the Spirit by the words of the law or by hearing with faith? Are you so foolish? Verse 3. Are you so foolish after beginning with the Spirit? Are you not going to be made complete by the flesh? In other words, because they have been bewitched, they started as Christians by obeying the word of God. And then somebody came and told them, look, you see,
Pastor Dan, he only wants your money. Oh. He only wants your money. See the kind of car he's driving? You are not driving that car. You are even walking. You don't even have a car like he has. And you're going to church every day and paying money to him. I mean, this bewitchment thing we're talking about is not about telling you big things. It's just a matter of a lot of small things that you will not think about. But listen to me. Whatever that person did is a seed that has been planted in you all years. Hallelujah. Before you know, you start thinking about what the person said. Before you know, you're sleeping, you can't sleep. Then it comes to Sunday. Because of the same words that you heard, you skip church. Then you call pastor and say, Pastor, I'm sick, I can't come to church. You have been bewitched. Those words that were coming to you, there were demons backing those words. And because you allow the person to continue speaking into your mind, the person has been able to sow a seed. So that seed will germinate. It will grow up. And then you come to a point in time you will not like Pastor Dan anymore. Oh, you leave Pastor Dan, I don't like you. You don't like me. He hates me. He did this. He said that. He did this. Look at what the other day that happened. You begin to think about things that are not there. Now you will start to insinuate and make certain situations to try to make it come to, you know, you back certain things up and then you are able to get a stand. And oh, I'll leave the church. You have been bewitched. Hallelujah. Be careful. Be extra careful. There are many Christians, they are never able to listen and obey. It is evil. It is rebellious. You see, if we don't listen to the word of God and do as it says, it will be difficult for God to do anything with us. We will struggle and struggle and struggle and without understanding why we have prayed and nothing is happening. We are allowing the work of witchcraft to be planted in us. You see, listen. Let's say I was watching this girl, 16-year-old girl, before coming to church. And the man died at a younger age. So she used to live with her father. And she said the father is a businessman. So at age 6, the father was busy working. So she was kind of lonely. So she said one day she had a dream. And in the dream, the dead mother, appeared in the dream and said, follow me. And she followed that mother and they went into a river. In that river, the mother picked up some of the river and initiated her. And some kind of like